Time's up. Game over. The fat lady sang a long time ago. By now, like the forewarned elite of global capitalism's old boys network, she probably packed up her troubles in her old kit bag, grabbed a few donuts, and on the way to cash her chips in. That, and watch the birds and banks of our planet go into free fall. The shift in the balance of powerful forces are evidently affecting the entire planet, the global environment, birds, fish, animals and insects, en masse. And for people, the effect of socio-cultural and economic polarization is becoming increasingly hard to avoid, let alone ignore. People are becoming polarized. The times are presenting frequent and unavoidable crisis points where people are having to make decisions, tough ones. It's happening across the world, from Egypt to England, and Algeria to America. It's polarization, and in its extreme form people are in the streets deciding which side of the barricades they should be on, coming to a street near you soon. Or not. Either way, unless or until then, all anyone can do is carry on eating the chips. Until they are down. Down to the point where the food supply and distribution infrastructure grinds to a halt. Then, all bets are off. When man finds out that he can, most definitely, live by bread alone. When gold and diamonds are worth less than potatoes and corn. And when we find out if the old adage was right, the one about the world being always just 3 meals away from revolution. It's not the end of the world. It's just time to take the world back. Back from the men who stole it, the men who stole it, and then had the gall to sell it back, again, and again, and again. For generations. But always for a profit. So it's not the end of the world. A world that for thousands of years has been treated as a commodity, governed by scientific materialism, and exploited by global capitalism. And for 99% of the people whose loss has always been profit, for the 1% who form the ruling elite of that system, it should be the start of a new age of creative power that will come from a share of ownership and global responsibility and global unity. Forgive? Sure. But forget? Well, we'll see about that. Lest anyone forget, there has been thousands of years of inhuman abuse, disregard for life, rape, exploitation, invasion and do what the hell we want and take what the hell we want attitude. Okay, maybe tough times are ahead for those who have had too much of a vested interest in maintaining the current global economic system of money laundering, stock market rigging, government subsidized bank bailouts, and other forms of global finance corruption. And for the worst of global capitalism's parasites, the old boys network, it's certainly not going to be easy adjusting to a world where the elitism, nepotism and old Etolonian, Huyanuism, is not as important as, hey buddy, you can get in the queue like the rest of us isms. So although it's easy to forgive a capitalist pig, after all, he can cry just as much as the pig he sold to the butcher. But it's not so easy to forget that he consoles his grief tonight dining on truffles and caviar, bought from the profits of bacon. And in a world governed by materialism, there is unavoidable erosion and loss of human compassion and spirit of humanity. Such have become alien to much of mankind, and at the expense of truffles, caviar, Nike trainers, and must-have mobile phone, life is comparatively cheap. Customers should note, the price paid for a soul can vary. And refunds do not apply.